We looked at what online auctions are like logistically in the last video, and now I wanted to share a little bit of my technique for finding items because it's totally overwhelming. There's all of these are going on right now, and probably more that are on these pages. And then look, there's 37 pages at least of auctions coming up, and each auction has hundreds of items potentially. So, how do you find auctions that have things you want? How do you find things, auctions that have prices that are in your realm of possibility? This is what I do. It's very unscientific, but it seems to find me some good things sometimes. These auctions on this site and on all the other sites I use are all over the map in terms of quality and pricing and style. There's tons of jewelry auctions, and it's modern jewelry, and even those the prices are all over the maps. Here's a antique art auction in China, and I bet this stuff's really expensive. I bet shipping it from China is ridiculous. So I'm not even gonna look at that. There's a certain amount you can figure out just from looking at their one cover photo and what they describe in the title, and also where it is. I as yet have not bid in any auctions that are not in the same country as me, just for shipping reasons. So, you can scroll through and something might catch your eye and you can look at it. But I tend to do this thing where I will search on the kinds of items that I like to buy in large lots and can sometimes find super cheap in auctions that are not specializing in them. And these tend to be sort of, I don't want to say low end, but not Rolexes, more like postcards. So when I scroll through the results for postcards, I can sometimes zero in on auctions that have a lot of postcards, that have lots of postcards, and or are not super expert in postcards, which are all things that I'm looking for. Although, sometimes people go to those auctions and bid them up crazy high anyway, but it's a start. Like, these look kind of sexy, but first of all, it's in the UK, and second of all, the starting bid is £30, so that's already too much. These, again, UK, and they're displaying them all nicely, just four at a time. Starting bid is £300, totally not happening. But this one, look, there are just a bunch of postcards on the floor. Now, I can kind of tell even from this poor picture that these are not probably the kind of postcards I'm interested in, but the starting bid is $10. I'm gonna look at this lot and see what I can figure out. Zoom in more. It's not a very high-res picture, so I can really kind of examine this as closely as possible. And there's more pictures with sort of close-ups. Honestly, this on first glance doesn't look that interesting to me, but if it were, I would scroll down and do explore this auction and see if they have more stuff like that. Seems like furniture. This looks like an estate. But this is the kind of, dare I say, slightly cruddy auction that I like, because there might be some nice secret good deals. Like, what's in here? There's sort of lots, big lots of things. This is the kind of estate sales that I like to go to and find treasures. So here's the postcard. So maybe there aren't a lot of postcards in this auction, but sometimes you'll click on one and find tons. Go back to my postcard search and I look for other things that are promising. Like, those look good, but starts at $500. I'm not gonna even look at that. Look at this one. It's a terrible picture. It's sideways. It starts at $2. I'm gonna go check out that auction, see if there's any deals. This is the same auction company. Look, is that a cyanotype? Maybe. I'm gonna look into this one. That's how I go about it. Now, of course, you might not be looking for the same kinds of stuff as me, but that's my technique. Basically, do a search on the kind of thing I'm interested in and then try to identify auctions by looking at how they are displaying that kind of thing. So I hope that technique is helpful for you and you can extrapolate and apply it to whatever you're looking for. I do find that, you know, just buying one expensive item in these is usually expensive, not like at an estate sale where you might find something cool like this postcard tucked in with books and get it in a lot for nothing, or in a bulk purchase for nothing. Yeah, this is $75 because somebody did some research and knows that it's good. So I hope that little technique is helpful and that you can extrapolate and use it for whatever you're interested in, be it high-end or low-end items, be it whatever kind of items. But that's the way I think about it. I hope it helps you find some cool stuff. And if you do find something you're definitely interested in or potentially interested in, there's a couple things you can do. First, you could just place your max bid now and hope for the best, and just they'll tell you if you win or if you're outbid when this auction actually happens on July 23rd. So you can just add it to your calendar, which is super helpful if you remember to look at your calendar during the pandemic. And you can just tune in when you need to and bid accordingly, see how things are going, if things are getting bid up, if things aren't getting bid up, and place your bid sort of real time. Please click the thumbs up and the bell, and thank you and take care.